Dear colleagues, namaste everyone. As management teachers, one of the most important tasks is research. Now, this is so because not only it contributes to our professional development, but also helps our institution and the nation. In fact, the research atmosphere is quite electrifying for management and the commerce teachers with the launch of STRIDE and the impressive schemes. And these are by the MHRD, as you know. Now, a teacher with a sophisticated research attitude and aptitude is an asset for any institution, and he or she can inspire students to pursue career in research and development and lead the doctoral scholars also to create socially purposeful and a research for the development of the nation. Now, with this backdrop, we bring to you some ideas on research in policy and governance studies, personal finance, ethos, consciousness studies, which are amongst the few emerging areas of research that are interested faculty members can definitely explore. Now, first let us look at some ideas on policy and governance studies.
Thank you, sir. Public policy as a discipline developed to address the unmet needs of society, considering local culture and context of the intended beneficiary. When public policy researchers and students undertake any study, they need to be aware of social realities and ground scenario, that is the ontology of their research phenomena. Many a times we find the policies are so esoteric in nature that they do not add value to the life of a common man. Some policies are made with good intentions but do not yield results. Further, we can also observe that implemented policies lead to unintended outcomes, and instead of improving the governance, they worsen the situation. The research philosophy, methodology, and methods which are disconnected from grassroots are responsible for not delivering the desired outcomes. So, what could be the possible solutions? A researcher should be grounded in a philosophy or an ideology before he or she begins the research. One should be very clear about the interpretive or a positivist or a postmodernist stance that is needed to be taken and why. Second aspect is a customized approach to be taken with respect to every population which is under research. A researcher is thus advised to have a sound knowledge of the local culture, context, and the realities before going for field survey, interviews, and other types of data collection. After data collection and analysis, one major responsibility for the researcher, especially in public policy and governance studies, is suggesting a proper implementation framework for the prescribed policy. The reporting should be simple, precise, and documented in unambiguous manner. Last but not the least, readiness and effectiveness with which the feedback is sought, evaluated, and changes are incorporated. This ensures agility in the process of research, keeping in mind the dynamic nature of this field.
So, yes, public policy is certainly an emerging area requiring good inputs from teachers of management. And another domain which is of significant importance is personal finance. Now, while research in the area of personal finance is picking up globally, that is in realization of the requirement of creating new knowledge, the domain is not much researched in the Indian context. And so, let me suggest you a few topics of research. Attitude of household investors towards personal finance and its relationship with their retirement planning capabilities could be one of the areas. Interestingly, one may replace retirement planning with any other component of personal finance. For example, liquidity planning, investment management, risk management, estate planning, and expenditure management. One may also confine oneself to women investors or rural investors, senior citizens in different geographical areas. And now you may imagine that there could be hundreds of research topics that you could that can emerge from the theme of personal finance. Also, very little research has happened on the role of personal financial advisors and attitude of stakeholders towards them. So, if you wish to do a path-breaking research, you should work on indigenous approach to personal finance, and the research can be undertaken by initiating a search on Google for BMFL, that is Bharti model of financial literacy, and research on finding financial literacy in Indian context. Similarly, cultural context in financial literacy could also be researched for various countries of the world, and new models of financial literacy could be explored. So, now you can think about the kind of potential which is there in the area of personal finance. Apart from personal finance, let me also tell you that you may work on BMDL, that is Bharti model of digital literacy, and HECR, that is holistic electoral competency rating. Now, for them, you need to Google and just check what these concepts are, and these are unresearched, so you can work on them. Another theme for people in finance could be HDMM, that is holistic decision making model. For HR, there is one more area which I can recommend, that is WLNF, work life natural fusion, which you know is an advance over work life balance. Now, for all these, if you wish to collaborate, you can write to us on fp@banasthali.in. Moving further, let us listen to Dr. Richa and Dr. Nilni on spirituality and the consciousness studies as the areas with huge research potential.
Thank you, sir. Workplace spirituality. Spiritual intelligence, better predictor for organizational performance. At the beginning of the 20th century, psychologists discovered ways and means to measure intelligence that developed into an obsession with intelligence quotient. Early 1990s, Daniel Goleman coined the term emotional intelligence, EQ. According to him, emotional intelligence is a fundamental prerequisite for the suitable use of intelligence quotient. Where IQ contributes 20% in success, EQ contributes 80% in success. Also, there is enough collective evidence from psychology, neurology, anthropology, and cognitive science to illustrate that there is a third Q, SQ, or spiritual intelligence. Spiritual intelligence is exceptionally human, and the authors argue the most fundamental intelligence. Ahmedin et al. 2013 define spiritual intelligence in that it is the ability in a person to build up dream and also give a willpower to accomplish that vision. Spiritual intelligence is what we use to develop our longing and competeness for implication, vision, and value. It allows us to dream and to strive. It underlies the thing we believe in and the role our belief and value play in the action that we take and the way we shape our lives. Spiritual intelligence is certain for human who comes to knowledge of a transcendent dimension, and this flexible intelligence empowers him to be creative and change its own rules and regulations. Also enables him to carry out numerous reforms and reshape the situation in the best way. Robert Immon defined spiritual intelligence, or SQ, as the adaptive use of spiritual information to facilitate everyday problem solving and goal attainment. He originally proposed 5 components of spiritual intelligence: the capacity for transcendence, the ability to enter into heightened spiritual states of consciousness, third, the ability to invest everyday activities, events, and the relationship with a sense of the sacred, the ability to utilize spiritual resource to solve problems in living, and the capacity to engage in virtuous behavior to show forgiveness, to express gratitude, and to humble, to display compassion. Spiritual intelligence is the mind capacity to handle substantial and the spiritual aspects of life. According to previous studies, spiritual intelligence can be effective in the promotion of different variables. One of them is organizational performance and sustainability. Research shows that there is a positive and significant relationship between spiritual intelligence and organizational performance. The spiritual intelligence empowers people to be creative and be able to change situation in the best way. With the advent of spirituality to the organization, better behavior will be available. people, those have high level of spiritual intelligence that are able to cope up with stress and uncertain situations. Spiritual intelligence of employees creates positive impact on organizational health. Spiritual intelligence plays a role in determining organizational success. Such, if there is a person having spirit to work and better ability to understand the feelings of oneself and others, then the chance of problem occurrence in the organizations become less. Spirituality at workplace can increase the productivity of employees and the organization. Spirituality development is required for growth of good management in the organization. There are principles of spiritual intelligence which are used by the organizations to improve their performance. These are self-awareness, spontaneity, being vision and value-led, holism, empathy, celebration of diversity, autonomy, humbleness, curiosity, ability to reframe, belongingness, positive use of adversity. Spiritual intelligence is an aptitude to access higher meanings, principles, enduring purposes, and unconsciousness fact of the personality and to implant these meanings, values, and the purposes in living more affluent and more creative lives. Symbols of high spiritual intelligence comprises a talent of out-of-the-box thinking, humbleness, and an access to energies that come from something beyond, from self-centeredness. Today, workplace spirituality is very important, and if organization wants to sustain in dynamic environment, then they had to become spiritually intelligent. Hence, this can be the area of research which needs to be explored more in other domains as well.
I am completely agreed with my colleague Dr. Richa Chauhan. In continuation, I would like to add that there could be one more research area related with spiritual intelligence, that is influence of spiritual intelligence as a predictor of academic achievement for university students. Though it is very important for organizations similarly, spiritual intelligence also has influence in the academic arena where it acts as a predictor of their academic achievements. Thousands of students enter to a higher education every year with high hopes and having a good and stable career. Many of them meet their expectations while others keep on struggling even for basics. Some enters with expectation of developing their social life and try to discover their true potentials. With the changing scenario, students are becoming more and more impatient. They are not able to handle failure and rejections, which make them committing suicide, misbehaving with others, indulge in negative activities, and so on. There could be many factors responsible for all this, but one factor that plays very important role is spiritual intelligence. The goal of higher education is to retain as many students as possible with good academic achievement. Academic achievement is one of the many challenges that students are facing and universities are also facing too. Physical change and mental development are closely related with spiritual and emotional intelligence. Higher education is the stage where students extend their relationship beyond parents and family and are intensely influenced by the peers and the outside world. If the level of spiritual intelligence is high among students, they will be able to deal with the stress well. MHRD report of 2011 on elementary education and literacy 12th five-year plan emphasize on adolescents' education and providing good programs, practical recommendations, and proposed financial outlay for adolescents' well-being. Students with high spiritual intelligence have the capacity to ask and think beyond boundaries, modify the system, work effectively in different situations, and become innovative. It encourages students to see the bigger picture of their surrounding world. Spiritual intelligence should be taught to the students before they experience the damaging effect of superficial stress. Mishra and Vashisht give five components of spiritual quotient are as follows. The first one, it has the capacity to go above the physical and material world. It has the ability to experience high level of consciousness. It can scantify each day experience. It helps in utilizing spiritual resources for problem solving. It helps in becoming more virtuous. This spiritual intelligence has different skills through which students can develop high self-awareness, in which they must have an awareness of own worldwide, awareness of own their mission, awareness of own values, hierarchy, complexity of inner thoughts, and mainly awareness of self-ego. Secondly, they should have universal awareness, where they must have an awareness of the interconnectedness of all life, awareness of worldwide related with others, awareness of their limitations, awareness of spiritual laws, and they should be experienced transcendence oneness. Next, they must have higher self-mastery, where they must have a commitment to spiritual growth, keeping higher self in charge, sustaining their faith towards something, and seeking guidance from the spirit. Lastly, they must have social mastery, where they need a wise and effective spiritual teacher or mentor who can help them in making wise decisions and help in aligning with the flow of life. Spiritual intelligence adds meaning to the life of students and allow them to use their IQ and EQ, because only spiritual quotient is capable of thinking beyond the limit and to connect with a brand new idea. Hence, we can say that spiritual intelligence refers to the skills, abilities, and behavior required to develop and maintain a relationship to the ultimate source and helps in succeeding in the searching of meaning of a life.
So here we conclude the module by re-emphasizing that let us research on the new and fruitful topics. And we recommend you to see this video at least twice to get ideas, and do not forget to discuss among yourselves to refine them further. And let us know your feedback on prime@banasthali.in. We trust that faculty members would shortly research in suggested areas and contribute to the development of self, society, and our great nation, India.